No, it's a phrase we're about to use. It's Jackie Tohn time. The world is going her way. Could it be better?
I don't know. I'm having a very nice day.
That's good.
Here.
Very nice.
Yeah, man. I feel real. I roll my eyes a little when actors are like, I feel so lucky and grateful. I feel so lucky and grateful. I don't know what to tell you.
So does that battle with cynicism? Do you know what I mean?
Well, of course. I'm a New York Jew, so I'm like, I don't, you know, there's like, people have it so much harder than me, and I know, and I was just telling you guys in the break, like, I didn't really get hired till I was in my mid-30s. Mm-hmm. So now I'm sort of like, could you kindly get out of my way while I...
Right, because it's my turn.
I've been acting since I was 9.
Yeah, good for you.
So it took a second.
No, but here you are. So, all right, a variety of glow questions.
Please.
You were dating a prostitute.
I'm currently in real life dating a prostitute.
No, that's not true.
I married him. Okay. I'm no longer dating him. We're betrothed. Yes, I, on Glow Season 3, pick up a guy at the bar, and I think he thinks I'm a prostitute. And my friends are mortified, and I'm like, are you kidding? I'm going to get paid to sleep with a guy I was going to sleep with for free. This is the greatest thing that's ever happened to me. Turns out the tables are turned, and at the end of the act, he's like, so do you need to go get cash? And I'm like, why, I'm the
Oh, wow. Did you ever see the short-lived and rather horrible Showtime series, Gigolos?
No, but the poor creators are like, God, it's horrible. No, I never saw it.
Oh, all right. Anyway, that was about that kind of stuff. All right, and then what about all the other characters?
What about them?
What's happening to them? Some becomes a president of a TV network. Ruth rejects being the director to pursue acting. Carmen will go on a wrestling tour with her brother. Bash wants to start a family.
There is a lot of stuff to behold in Glow Season 3. There's wrestling, there's...
How much hairspray?
Ladies making out. There's all sorts of people making out. And I would say 7 to 12 pallets
of Aquanet.
I mean, we're sitting there in hair and makeup in the morning, just meticulously getting rhinestones glued to our faces. I mean, it's such a dream. And to have that many... You know, women in one place, women in charge, women writing, women directing, women starring. It's really, it's like a glorified, incredible sleepover party where you also get, like, as an actor, I'm getting handed the deepest and most meaningful work I've ever gotten to do while also, like, laughing and shaking your body. Yeah. I was going to say boobs, it's the news. You know, just being silly and fun, but also really deep and grounded, and it's... I don't know.
That's great, though.
I can't think of that many shows that allow you to do that.
Yeah. All right, let's talk about Spell.
Let's, please.
What's it about?
Spell is an indie film that we made about a cartoonist, basically an illustrator, whose girlfriend, me, passes away, and he needs to get away. He goes to Iceland. And while in Iceland, he runs out of his OCD medication.
Uh-oh.
And what then happens over the course of the movie... We sort of don't know if they're his sort of OCD tics or if the occurrences happening are the work of mysterious otherworldly things because of sort of wizardry that's going on. And it's a thriller, but it's also funny and interesting and deep and brilliantly directed and written. And it's a beautiful, I hate to say this, it's a beautiful little movie.
Yeah. But you know what?
It's not Iron Man, but it's a beautiful and incredible and deep and powerful movie.
Now, some did. Did you get to go to Iceland?
Listen to this. The whole crew, well, a teeny tiny little crew, so sound and our director and Barrick Hardley, who's the writer and star of the movie, this tiny crew went to Iceland. I shot in a cabin in Frogtown.
Oh.
I said, Jackie, that's right by the freeway. Why don't you head down here?
Right, we'll see you later.
You just take the two. And in fact, you don't have to exit. It's on top of the freeway.
Yeah.
And they're all like in Iceland in like little toques.
Yeah.
Wow.
Get out of here.
Oh, you so rarely get the instruction, though, to take the two.
And not only did I take it, I didn't have to exit.
Right, perfect.
It makes it easier than that.
That's right.
All right, do you have any time for fun?
I have so much time for fun.
So what are you doing for fun?
Oh, I thought you meant right now. I was like, ask me anything, Ruben.
Sure.
Yeah, I have a lot of time for fun. I mean, really, it's interesting. I'm in such a lucky place. I'm making a cartoon, an animated preschool musical series for Amazon with Kristen Bell, who you look like.
Yeah.
And
thank you.
We are... So when I say have time for fun, I mean, I'm writing the music for that show.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I'm voicing it, and I created it and executive produced. So
when you said,
you said, do I have time for fun? And I was like, yeah, I'm writing all these songs. But then I realized, oh, wait, that's work.
But work can be fun. See,
that's
but
really
that's okay.
Together.
It is really
It's
fabulous.
All going Jackie's way, and I'm going to put in a request for a Hanukkah gift. Spell is out in select theaters now. It's available on video on demand. It'll drop next week on Tuesday, November 19th. Really good to see you this morning.
I'd like a Vitamix.
Okay.
Yeah. A Vitamix.
Yeah. Do you want a Vitamix?
Yeah, I feel like they're high priced, but sort they of like are. Within the range of a gift.
Okay.
So I'd like a
All right. Good. Thanks, Jackie.
Thanks for having me, guys.